Welcome back, seamers and others who are interested in making this swimsuit. What you have here is a one-piece multi-wear bodysuit slash bathing suit. Let's start with the folded piece of fabric. What you're going to do is fold it together, ugly side out, and we're going to go ahead and sew that piece. Before you begin sewing or handling the fabric, make sure to file your nails so you have no catching pieces. Take your time, thread your machine. It's always fun. I could do this without looking, actually. Lightning speed. I have my machine set for a zigzag, very close together and very short. So a short zigzag, close together. Now, with the folded piece of fabric, you're going to take the open end, starting at the edge where the fold begins, and you're going to seal that and bring it all the way around. Here you can see the zigzag that I have. Let's go ahead and sew that all up. At the end, you're going to go ahead and turn it, and I'll show you a close up of that. Needle down, lift your foot, turn your material. I use my entire arm and hand to keep the material steady as I sew, and I continue to correct it as I go just to make sure the two sides match or that there's no warped material. Here you see we've come to the end where we're meeting the fold again, and we're going to stop there. Do your knot. And we're gonna go ahead and pull this. Well, actually, you can see the opening so you can pull it inside out. I'll show you how to do that later. Let's move on to the next. Make sure to have both pretty sides facing each other, so your ugly side out. And I don't like to waste material, so I'm using the edge of my fabric. Sew the entire thing closed just like the other. With this one, as you just saw, I left a slot. So I sewed two edges and I left a little slot, and I'm going to continue down. So just like the other one, we have an open space. Finishing it off. There we are. So let me show you really quickly how I pull it inside out. The slot is big enough to basically fit my whole hand in there, but I don't have to put my whole hand. All you have to do is go in and grab a piece of the fabric and pull it inside out, as you see. Ta-da! We have two finished straps or sashes, whatever you want to call them, onto the bottom, your swimsuit bottom. Hopefully, yours looks like this. Flip your fabric so the two sides are facing in. And sew along your edges. I'm sewing right on the edge because I don't have a serger. The zigzag stitch does a perfect job as well. So if you don't have a surgery, that's fine. Coming to an end, close it off. Sewing up the other side. Start with a knot and sew. Always start and end with a knot. I'm sure all of you know that. But just in case, I'd like to say it. Don't want anything falling apart. Now, sewing the crotch. Start with a knot, end with a knot. Zigzag still. Guess what? The first layer is done. Woo! Remember, your waist should have the most stretch. The length of it doesn't really need the stretch. So here we are, layer two. Quick tip, when you're using a swim material or something with extra stretch, after you've added your knot, use that string to pull the material through so your machine doesn't eat your fabric. And there it is, layer two finished. Now, take the two pieces inside out, so seam side out at the leg. Put the matching pieces together, and if you'd like, you can pin them. So, here in slow motion, your crotch down to your front of the leg, and here is the back underbum area. So, go ahead and pin that together if you really like to. And right now the pieces are side by side. Slide that onto the machine. So that's your crotch, and you're gonna pin alongside matching sides of the two different pieces of fabric. Now, this is the easy side. So, just sew it all up. If you would say the two pieces are ugly side out, so right now they're together, one inside the other, pretty side facing each other. So, ugly sides out, pretty sides in. And when you flip that inside out, you have perfection. Again, your two pieces of separate fabric in the jagged edge of the outside of both together. So your wearable or finished sides are facing each other right now. Again, you're going to pin the jagged edge. pin the inside of your side seams. And work your way around again like you did the other side. As you come closer to the crotch, force the pieces to line up along the edge and pin it as close as you can to that crotch, because again, because it's because you're on the inside of the two walls, it's gonna give you a little bit of a fight, but pull it out as much as you can and pin that. Here I'm showing you I've pinned all the way around from where you saw resistance earlier to here is where the resistance is again, where the crotch piece is sewn at the other end. So here we go. Make sure you don't have any pieces rolled in. Get it as close to that crotch as possible. And start. By pushing the fabric under the needle, what I'm doing is forcing the fabric on the outside or underside to lay correctly. Just occasionally pull the fabric from the unfinished end and make sure they're lined up nicely, that there are no wrinkles underneath. Lift the foot, turn, lay the foot, and continue to sew all the way around. Again, as you go where you're sitting, you can see if the fabric is lined up, top and bottom, lined up correctly. Just make sure it's laid correctly and that there are no wrinkles that you're sewing into the fabric. Use your hands again as guides to push it through gently, not pulling or not giving it any extra resistance. And this is the tricky part where you have to force the material out in order to complete the full circle of the other leg. I think this is the most difficult part of making this entire swimsuit or bodysuit. Of course, if you're making it one layered, you don't really have to worry about this. You just hem the bottom. It's a struggle, but you can do it.